Told you. Okay. Question for today. I love questions. So if you have a question, make sure you send it on in. Usually it's something to do with business, but it doesn't have to be. It could be politics, faith, religion. Well, those are kind of similar. Similar, not the same. Relationships, whatever. Just send a question. I love answering questions. Today's question, I don't know who it's from. It came in without a name. But it says, Josh, why is becoming a successful inventor so hard? And why is it hard to market a new product? Ooh, that's a good question. That's a good question. There's actually two sort of elements to this. We'll take the first part first. Why is it so hard to become a successful inventor? Well, the reason is because you typically have inventors who do not treat their invention like a business. They treat it like their baby. Or like that little Lord of the Rings, that little Gollum. It's my precious. Right? They just will not let go of this thing. So they strangle it to death. You see this on shows like Shark Tank all the time, right? Like if it's something the dude or the dudette invented, well, I'll give you $4 million for 51%. No, I could never lose control of my baby. The richest guy on the planet only owns 16% of his company. So they hold on to this little invention way too hard. They think that nothing else in the world is better than it, even though many times there's something extremely similar being invented by somebody else at the same time. It's amazing how that happens. I have a theory on that, but we don't have to get into that. And they're not approaching it as, okay, how do I market and sell this product? They just... And typically, it's all they focus on is the invention, not the business that's supposed to be built around the invention. Does that make sense? So that's problem number one. Problem number two, sometimes your invention sucks. Sorry. Your invention might be the coolest thing to you, but sometimes it just sucks. And I say that not to disincentivize or discourage you. But just because you come up with something that's amazing doesn't mean that the person wants it, needs it, or is going to buy it. That's just not how any of this works. As a matter of fact, some of the best inventions are never going to be commercial successes because one, they're too expensive. Two, it's too hard to produce or replicate. Three, you know, there's too much of an education rewrite for the general population that needs to happen in order for them to appreciate it, or a number of other reasons. Make sense? Now, let's say you have an invention that's good. Let's say you have an invention that you're not strangling to death, like that abominable snow monster and Bugs Bunny. I want to pet him and love him and sweet, right? Let's say you're past that. We then have to market the thing. Why is it so hard to bring something new to market? One, you have everybody who you're displacing who want to fight you tooth and nail. It's not like the inventor of this microphone wants to open the floodgates to somebody else who makes a better microphone. No. Well, come on in. Yeah, take all my money. Displace all my employees. Make me poor. Come on in. Yeah, just bring it in. Nope, that's not how any of that works. So that's your first challenge. Second challenge is the business sense of the inventor is typically not there. We kind of covered that a second ago, but it's typically not there. They're not thinking, how do I market it? How do I brand it? The brand is the most important aspect. Brand of a new product is actually more important than copyright or trademark or patent or whatever your thing is, in my opinion. And I have a lot of economic proof to prove that. So... including KFC, Amway, and a bunch of other companies. So there's a reality to that. And then third, you have to get into the marketplace in such a way that either A, you spend a ton of your own money on advertising and marketing campaigns. B, you take on investors, which a lot of inventors don't want to do, or they get ripped off by because they've never done it before. Three, the distribution system for that industry just doesn't want to take it for a number of reasons. Usually that has to do with larger competitors paying that distribution chain not to take it. See, you have this idea. you have this idea that if you come up with a really great product or something, that stores might just fall over it. Oh man, this is just so amazing. We want this. Can we just fall over you forever? Nope. As a matter of fact, I'll use my own experience with this. So I have a beverage company, and that beverage company is obviously smaller than the giant titans that are in the space now. And some of those giant titans will actually tell the distributors, hey, if you take Josh's product, you're not going to be able to carry ours. Well, even though I think that's low, from the distributor standpoint, I can understand their decision because I'm not going to be bigger than the big dogs for years. So why would you want to risk it? So the same thing is true with whatever invention or whatever you have. So those are some of the reasons. My suggestion, though, because I just don't want to tell you why it doesn't work. My suggestion for you is if you're an inventor, study business. Because I know you think you're just a scientist or an artist or an engineer, whatever. You're not. You're just not. You are a business person who happens to have those skills. Now you have to develop that business person side of you. Stay away from kind of the cheesy courses or the, you know, we represent inventors, that sort of crap. Usually it's crap. Or the ClickFunnels sort of, you know, get your invention to market. Sign up now. 3 months off our membership course. Ugh. Stay away from that too. But get some serious business knowledge. Look for real investors. Going to people who are in your supply chain for your invention typically make for great investors because they get it. They understand it. They'll see it. They understand the benefit, not only to you, but to them. So that would work. And just focus a lot on the brand and the marketing. Brand and marketing. Because what you want to do is you want to create a name and a presence for yourself that even if somebody copies you, it's a little too late. Once they come to market, because you've already established a name. And whether we want to believe it or not, people buy names. They really do. Your brand is by far the most important part of your business. So make sure you build it. So anyway, that is the answer to that question. Again, if you have questions for me, send an email to info@joshtully.net. Just put in the subject line, question for Josh. And we'll put you in the rotation. We have a lot in front of you, but we'll put it in the rotation. Remember also to subscribe to the show, whether that's on YouTube or your podcast provider or Twitter or Instagram or Facebook or whatever you have. If you are watching this on Instagram, give us a like, a thumbs up, a notification bell, and a subscribe. And of course, share it with everybody. Remember to look into jury nullification. No victim, no crime. Today, tomorrow, and as always, my friends, may your path lead to heaven, and may freedom follow in your footsteps.